This is an original 1964 French Grande poster for the Stanley Kubrick film Dr. Strangelove. This poster was heavily creased, and we flattened it out on a linen backing. See how we did it today on Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Poster Fix. Today, Dr. Strangelove. It's a folded poster, and I'm going to unfold it. These folio creases are heavy, and they can be flattened out only through linen backing. It's in really, really good condition.
Wow, other than the folio folds, the condition is awfully good.
So I'm going to linen back this poster, but first I have to prepare a screen. Dr. Strangelove, or How I Learned to Stop Worrying and Love the Bomb. That's the title of this movie. But it's more commonly known as simply Dr. Strangelove. And it is a 1964 black comedy film that satirizes the Cold War fears of a nuclear conflict between the Soviet Union and the United States of America. The film was directed, produced, and co-written by Stanley Kubrick and stars Peter Sellers, George C. Scott, Sterling Hayden, and Slim Pickens. The film was made in the United Kingdom. The film is loosely based on Peter George's thriller novel, Red Alert, from 1958. As you can see, I'm rolling out the acid-free paper onto the canvas. This is what the poster will get mounted to. And it's important that the paper be snug all around the perimeter so that it dries tightly and creates a good linen backing and doesn't allow water to seep in.
So the screen has been prepared with acid-free paper, so now we can linen back this Dr. Strangelove French Grande, which we will do after this commercial break. So don't go away. In an upcoming Poster Fix video, you're going to see us linen back this six-sheet poster for Earth versus the Flying Saucers, printed in 1956. Okay, we're back in the Poster Fix shop, and we're going to mount this French Grande for Dr. Strangelove onto this screen, which I've prepared with acid-free paper. Let's go.
Let's see, the plot of Dr. Strangelove, or How I Learned to Stop Worrying and Love the Bomb. The story concerns an unhinged U.S. Air Force general who orders a first strike nuclear attack on the Soviet Union. It separately follows the President of the United States, his advisors, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and a Royal Air Force exchange officer as they attempt to prevent the crew of the B-52 plane, who were following orders from the general, from bombing the Soviets and starting a nuclear war. The film is often considered one of the best comedies ever made, as well as one of the greatest films of all time. In 1998, the American Film Institute ranked it 26th in its list of the best American movies. In the 2007 edition, the film ranked 39th. And in 2000, it was listed as number 3 on its list of the funniest American films. In 1989, the United States Library of Congress included Dr. Strangelove as one of the first 25 films selected for preservation in the National Film Registry.
I'm spraying Dr. Strangelove with water so that it will help it expand. The paper is porous and it expands as it absorbs the wheat paste and absorbs the water. Thank you. And so we've got Dr. Strangelove French Grand linen back, and we're going to let it dry for a few days before we trim it down. Don't go away, we'll be right back. In an upcoming Post-Fix video, you're going to see us linen back this 6-sheet for Earth versus the Flying Saucers from 1956. It's in many pieces, and it's going to be quite a project. Don't miss it on Post-Fix.
Linen backing makes your posters stronger so that they last longer. If you have any questions about restoration, get in touch with me and I'll try to answer your questions as best I can.
Well, a few days have passed and it's time to trim down the poster. Peter Sellers had multiple roles in this movie. Columbia Pictures agreed to finance the film if Peter Sellers played at least 4 major roles. The condition stemmed from the studio's opinion that much of the success of Kubrick's previous film, Lolita, was based on Sellers' performance in which his single character assumed a number of identities. Sellers had also played 3 roles in The Mouse That Roared. Kubrick accepted the demand. Sellers ended up playing 3 of the 4 roles written for him. He had been expected to play the Air Force Major T.J. King Kong, the B-52 aircraft commander, but from the beginning, Sellers was reluctant. He felt his workload was too heavy, and he worried he would not properly portray the character's Texan English accent. Kubrick pleaded with him, and he asked the screenwriter Terry Southern, who had been raised in Texas, to record a tape with Kong's lines spoken in the correct accent, which he practiced using Southern's tapes. But after the start of shooting in the aircraft, Sellers sprained his ankle and could no longer work in the cramped aircraft mock-up. Sellers is said to have improvised much of his dialogue, with Kubrick incorporating the ad-libs into the written screenplay, so the improvised lines became part of the canonical screenplay, a practice known as retroscripting. Now I'm touching up the poster using water-reversible archival markers. Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix. Remember, at Poster Fix, we love to bring your vintage posters back to life.